Okay, so we need one of these equations to tell us what to use for substitution. So, good, minus 2y in the first equation, and we'll have that equation exactly like we want. So x equals negative 11 minus 2y, negative 2y minus 11. Now we know that x is the same as negative 11 minus 2y. They are exactly the same. So, just like bathroom and restroom are interchangeable, now we know that x and a negative 11 minus 2y are interchangeable, substitutable. 2 times negative 11 minus 2y minus y equals 13. We replace x with something that's exactly the same as x equals x. Distributing the 2, we get negative 22 minus 4y minus y. Let's see, combine these like terms, you get negative 22 minus 5y equals 13. Add 22 to both sides. Negative 5y equals 35. Divide by negative 5. And y is negative 7. Now we know y is negative 7, we'll just come right back to this equation and find x. X equals negative 11 plus 14. So x is 3 negative 7.
Yep,
that's what I got. I did. I got 18.5.
Did you take those?
No. I already know what I did wrong. I didn't think.
Wait,
we're going to need to do the same thing. We're going to need to be able to get x or y in one of the equations by itself. Okay, but it's going to require just a little bit more work than just subtracting 2y from both sides. Because in the equation that I suggested you use, it has a coefficient in front of x.
You know,
number 11.
Okay, thanks.
So the suggestion was that you use this first equation and that you solve for x in that first equation. We'll see why in a second why it's nice. So we'll just move over here and solve for x. So somebody help me solve for x.
Right here.
Trace?
Subtract 8y from both
Subtract
sides.
Subtract 8y from both sides.
And then divide each side by, or yeah, divide each side by 2.
Good.
Awesome.
So
it would stay like that one.
Could.
Because you can leave it the same because it doesn't matter what.
What's that?
It's negative 1.
Yeah, so I would take negative 2 divided by 2, you get negative 1. Negative 8 divided by 2 is negative 4y.
See, that, I mean.
Now, if you left it negative 2 minus 8y over 2, it's still correct. And if you do all the work out, like, meticulously, you'll get the same answer. But it would be easier to just simplify and divide everything.
I forgot the divide.
So now we know that x is equal to negative 1 minus 4y. And we use this equation, so we're going to want to substitute into this equation right there for x.
Negative 1.
So what are we going to do now?
Distribute.
Let's see, negative 3 minus 12y plus 5y equals negative 10.
Look at that.
Add both sides. We get, well, we can combine these together, right? We'll get negative 7y equals negative 7, and y equals 1. Now we have this equation. That could easily tell us what x is if we give it a y, and we know y is 1. So x equals negative 1 minus 4 times 1. X equals negative 1 minus 4, negative 5. Negative 5, comma 10.